everyone. So I thought today I would show you setting up for my Christmas hamster cage tour. So the hamster I have is Draco, who is a very, very old hybrid dwarf hamster. So I'm not sure if he'll make an appearance during this video. If he doesn't, I will insert some footage I took when I changed his cage around last week. He is getting old and doddery, so I am starting to scatter feed him and not feed him in a bowl. Okay, let me get you out of there. Okay, so I've taken his bowl away, but you saw the Christmassy bowl. So that is why he doesn't have any second levels, any hanging toys, anything really that exciting. Everything in this enclosure is pretty flat, and it's just because he is now struggling to get about as much as he used to. He's gone over there, he's going to go back to sleep to recover from his ordeal. So his enclosure isn't as exciting as I'd like to make it. It is fairly flat, and this is why you've just got to cater to your older animals. So Draco, as always, is in the IKEA D12, which is a IKEA shelving unit that has been flipped on its back with the shelves taken out and the doors taken off. So this is where he lives. It provides over 1,000 square inches of floor space, so it's a really good size for him. It's almost too good a size at the moment because he is so old and doddery. So that's why he's got a water bottle each end, because then he's never too far away from his water. And the only trouble with his bedding is he is basically invisible. He turns into a piece of bedding. So the bedding he's got is Fitch bedding. It is a nice, soft, fluffy, paper-based bedding. It's not scented, it's not dusty, it holds up tunnels really well, and he really enjoys it. It's a bit like Carefresh. So if I start over in this corner, he doesn't spend as much time in this corner now. He's got his Living World water bottle, so he's got one each side, so he's never too far away from his water. And over here, he's got a little elf door, which is absolutely adorable. It's made of like a resin type material, so he can't chew it. And then he's got a Santa, please stop here sign, which is made of plastic, so I've put that out of his reach. So here he's got his flower pot, which is filled with some shredded paper bedding and some of the Fitch bedding again. So this one isn't particularly Christmassy, but he does enjoy it, so I've left it in there where it normally is. I don't want to confuse him too much in his old age. So here we have a tea light holder, but it's actually completely open at the back, so it also doubles as a kind of hide. And this is one that I got from the pound shop, I think it was last year or the year before. And then we've got this gorgeous little snacks for Santa pot. So this one also was from the pound shop a year or two ago. And what I've done is I filled it up completely with Fitch bedding, because if he fell in there, he wouldn't be able to get out. And I've also sunk it down in his bedding as well, so he doesn't have to reach up to get it. He can just walk up to it. And then in there, I've put some little treats. There's some dried mealworms. There's a tiny bit of millet spray, but he's not allowed that very often. It's quite sugary. And then he's also got some natural grasses and sprigs of various seeds and stuff that he can have. So he does really enjoy chewing them. So here he has this gorgeous little train tunnel, which I got from Pets at Home, I think it was last year in the sale. And I filled that again with some paper-based kind of nesting materials. And then I sprinkled some Fitch bedding on the top, so it kind of looks like it's been snowed on. So he has a little gingerbread man loofah chew. He's got his usual sand bath. I mean, I can't really give him anything different, because anything with higher sides he would not be able to get in and out of. But he does occasionally have a roll around in that, and he also uses it to pee in, so that's fun. So along the back here, I've used these tiny little fairy lights. This is actually a piece that was meant for scrapbooking, but I've taken off the sticky backs, they didn't stick to the glass, and then I've just tied that up with thread. Again, that's out of his reach, so he can't chew that even if he tried, but yeah, I just think that looks adorable. He's got his own tiny little fairy lights. He's just kind of burrowing along like a little slug. So I forgot to change the backdrop to a more Christmassy backing. So because it's got glass on the back as well, you can just put any wrapping paper you like behind it to change the background. And honestly, I forgot. So last minute, I just stuck a Christmas Christmas hat on a llama. And now it's a Christmassy backdrop. So he's still got his flying saucer here if he decides he wants to exercise. Honestly, he's too old now and he's not mobile enough, so he doesn't use this, but the option's always there for him. Sometimes he climbs up on it and sits on it, but that's about as energetic as he gets. So he's still got his little hobbit house. This is one of his favourite houses, so I didn't take it out, but I have added this little wooden stocking. How cute is that? And that's just wood that's been cut out. That again, I think, was from Pets at Home. That was in a set. And then he's got this little wooden Santa. So this is adorable. I mean, it does have rope arms, so if he chewed it too much, I'd have to take it out, because that's not the sort of thing that you want them ingesting or getting wrapped around their teeth, or pouching to try and take in for a nesting material. It's not the sort of thing that you really want to leave unattended with a major chewer. He's unlikely to touch it, but it's one of those things I'll keep an eye on. So up here he has his Christmas tree. And this again is like a natural, is it like a seagrassy material or a corn husk? I can't remember what type of material it is, but it's all natural. It's fine for him to chew. So he's got another loofah chew here. This is actually one of his favourites, but because it's red, it gets to stay. This is looking pretty festive. So I've just sat that up on top there. And here's the entrance to probably his favourite house. This is a glass jar that I actually picked up in the charity shop. It's got some shredded paper bedding in there, and then I've just covered it up with bedding so he can also walk over the top as well without slipping and sliding around. But that's probably his favourite house. That's where he spends most of his time. So there's also a load of toilet roll tubes buried under the substrate, and this is more just a habit that I've got into with him. He used to really enjoy it, not so much anymore. But this is a toilet roll tube that goes down into kind of a network of toilet roll tubes under here. So it's a really deep area of substrate over the back. So that's kind of where he would do all his digging if he chose to do so. And then up on top of here, he's got his Christmas dinner. How cute is this? This again was from Pets at Home. I picked that up in the sale as well. And it's just adorable. So it's got these little parsnips, carrots, Brussels sprouts, some stuffing and a turkey. And they're all different natural kind of chewing materials. And they're all in this bowl and they're all just tied in there with natural string as well. So it's all safe for him to chew. And in the corner here, hung up on the bars of the detolf, is a little Brussels sprout with a smiley face. So this isn't one that he can realistically reach, but it looks pretty cute up there. So I also decided he was missing a wreath. So I spent more time than I care to admit trying to make him a little paper wreath. So this again is stuck up on the side out of reach, but if he did manage to reach it, it is made with non-toxic paper. So I tried to make little leaves and berries. I'm not quite sure how that worked, but it kept me busy for a minute. And then down in this corner, we have got his other water bottle. So he's got one on each side. And then we've got just some rocks, something a little bit more natural for him, although he's kind of buried them in bedding a bit. But they're sitting on the base of the detolf so that even if he dug under, you know, it wouldn't fall and squish him. So there's Draco down in his little burrow. It doesn't look like he wants to have anything to do with today's cage tour, so I will have to put in some clips of him from last week when I last switched around his cage, so you can at least see him toddling around and enjoying stuff. there's a bit of an overview of his Christmassy themed enclosure. It's quite tricky to show you because of the glare on the glass, but hopefully you get a general gist of what it's looking like overall. So I also forgot to show you actually that buried in his bedding we have another couple of Christmassy themed chews. So we've got this wooden holly leaf, and then I also made him some little holly leaves as well out of paper so he can find those if he wants to. So I really hope you've enjoyed seeing Draco's cage tour. So like I say, it's not as exciting as it could be because he's not able to interact with as many toys as he used to be able to. But I feel like I've made it festive and he gets to join in with the Christmas fun as well. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. And I will see you guys soon. Bye!